All right, folks. We're on the second hole at Northumberland Links in Pugwash, Nova Scotia. Beautiful course. We're on the water today. Some events happened on the first that we're not very proud of. And now Josh is up on this 350-yard par 4 with Big Stick. Drawing that towards the left-hand traps, big bounce.
That's where actually it is.
He might be safe. It landed on grass for sure. Took a big hop forward. I don't know.
It's quite the layout up there.
This is one of my favorite courses. I usually try and come play this every summer. Bruce has never been before.
It's a good time.
Tyler is joining Josh left. Ooh,
oh, that's bad.
That's in the fescue.
And next up on the tee, we have Ben Cameron.
I've changed your accent again.
Apparently, they all want something to bitch about. Starting with my accent. I'm a little concerned right now because the line that Josh and Tyler have shown me is left, but I think the flag is right.
Third.
And of all people, I didn't think Ben would be the one showing me the line.
That went nowhere.
I don't know why you thought it would.
Anyways.
Try it. It's only 350.
Here, one of you is.
Now we have everybody's favorite act, showing us what not to do on the course on the first hole, but you didn't get to see that, so that's good. And he's gone right.
Not that bad.
Not that far right, but...
I never saw it down.
And I don't know how he hit that, but he's definitely chasing it.
I got
160. We found Tyler in the fescue. This is gonna be a real treat. Playing down to the green over the bunker here. Josh's ball is just there. Oh, he hacked it out. It's in the fairway.
It's a back pin position too.
He'll probably have like a 40-yard pitch to a back flag, up and down for par. I didn't catch Bruce. I don't know what happened. Where'd it go, Bruce?
Landed on the green.
Bruce went in the general direction of the green. And Josh has drawn that in right at the flag.
Sit.
With no spin.
Oh,
that's good.
Oh,
he may have held the back of the green. He's going to have like a 15-foot putt.
As you can see, Tyler's hacked it out. Not bad line, but definitely well short. Not surprising with the lie, to say the least. Looking pretty good. Oh, what a shot. What a shot. And the camera can see it. Even better. Now let's see if we can't zoom out. Actually catch Ben. Oh, and the slope is taking that one away.
I need to carry that a couple feet further.
As we slowly wait for Bruce to walk towards his ball,
tell me to get it.
I'm gonna press the power button.
Bruce pitching on. Has to come over a hump to a back flag that's well protected. I kind of came off that mound, so I have like a 20-foot par putt, which sucks. These greens are lightning fast. That's a thin bullet. Thin bullet. And that's gone through the green. Oops.
Just squeeze it on.
Bruce is now on the putting surface.
And in my way.
We got Ben here putting for par, I believe.
It actually broke towards the bunker.
Josh putting for himself.
I wish the camera could see. Yeah, so as mentioned, the greens are fast. Josh just ran a 12-foot birdie putt from just off the fringe.
Do a 12-foot birdie putt back up.
Oh, it's not birdie anymore, Josh.
Prayer putt. Oh, of course. Little snip, snip, some editing. And it's a birdie putt.
Bruce lagged that one down to 4 feet by the hole. They are quick.
That's terrible. That was an awesome show.
Here, I'll
just finish it out. Great putt. I'll edit that in. Beautiful day. Contrary to popular belief, we all can putt, just not right now. It's because we're used to those Chambers Bay greens at Abercrombie. Third hole, I forget the yardage, we have 216. To the 150. This is probably in the 360 range. Bruce has got 4 iron. And he thinned that, unfortunately. We've got 230 to carry the bunkers on the right. Yeah, you just came up out of that, did that stupid lean thing. Our head pro told Bruce that he has to feel more like Shakira at impact, get some active hips in there. Bruce has really been taking that advice to heart. Beauty.
Perfect.
That's actually perfect.
Just make sure he carries that. No, and in the bunker.
And Tyler's in the bunker.
And sad face.
As you can see by the flag down there, we do have a significant headwind.
You can see a flag?
On the last green. Then after this hole, we're going to go down to the water for a little jaunt, and we will have the wind at our backs for a change. Also, I apologize for the viewers having to witness me hit driver. Josh with a high draw back into the middle of the fairway. Should be good. Yeah, that's a real good ball. That drive went about 225 yards.
I'm impressed too. No, that's a great tee shot.
And next up we have Chicken Wing.
Chicken Wing, not Chicken Legs?
Maybe both.
Genetic. It's genetic.
Genetically modified. Yeah. He had to get a special shaft put on his golf club.
Male model in male form.
Ooh, that's just mean.
I'm too hairy for that. That is just me.
Oh!
Look at this. It's gonna work.
Something I haven't seen in a while. That was excellent.
Perfect.
I think that finished in the middle of the fairway.
Show muscles. There we go. Bruce is second.
that's so good.
Oh, hang on.
Get left.
Get over
there.
Yeah,
it is. It's hanging.
Oh, it even bounced the right way.
I think you're on the... All right, so we reached our balls in the fairway. I just got Josh by a few yards. Tyler's caught the fairway bunker. Bruce just hit 8-iron out of the rough from roughly 200 yards into the wind, and he is pin high on the right fringe. It doesn't even make sense. Anyway, we've got Josh out of the fairway. It's a pretty straightforward green as far as I can remember. Just gonna fly it to the front edge and chase it back to the hole. These greens are really firm today too, so you can't really fly them all the way back. Not that we're good enough to do that consistently anyway. That's dead on the flag if it's up. It's up?
Oh, I think I bit in after I got up. Oh, no, there it
is. He's kind of on the middle of the green. I'm guessing 15 feet for birdie?
Yeah, probably something like that.
Okay. Here, Bruce.
Next up, we have Ben Cameron about 125 yards out from the green. And he's definitely on the green. He might be off the green as well. All right, now that Tyler's done adjusting the bunker for his shot. That is looking pretty good. All right, here we have Ben Cameron playing his third shot onto the green.
Oh!
Oh!
You get that on camera?
And he holed out. That is fantastic.
That's seven this year.
Next up, we have Tyler. He's just going to do a little bump and run up the hill. Excellent shot. And
soft bounces aren't the common thing. You got a really soft bounce.
Yeah, I know. I even landed just before.
Tyler just tapped in to save par. Bruce has got like a 20-25 foot birdie putt from just off the green. And Josh has about 20 feet from the front of the green. Huh. Just didn't catch the ball. Two birdies. That's a putt. If Bruce scraps up and down for par, we just played this hole two under par. Oh, he pulled it. Realistically, that's not a bad bogey from where your tee shot was. Here we are on the signature fourth hole at Northumberland Links. Josh and I both fresh off birdies. 173 to the flag. Abandoned boat and bunkers in back of the green, a pot bunker in front, and some water to the left. Josh has 7-iron. Slinging a draw in, except the wind's holding it. Probably not enough club.
Alright, next up we have Tyler Streit. Stealing Ben's honors, apparently.
Somebody wasn't ready, and we play ready golf.
Ben was.
Did you switch balls, Josh?
No.
I have switched balls.
He said that for the camera. Good job.
I don't care. No, it's good. It's used to the water.
Oh, Ben's setting it up.
Oh, no.
Well, that was an excellent shot by Tyler Streit. We were suffering some camera difficulties, and there may have been a short outage. We do apologize, but next up is Ben Cameron on the signature par. On the signature number 4 hole. Oh goodness, we had another service outage. That was an excellent shot by Ben Cameron.
So, last person on the tee. Not a single one of us have hit the correct shot for the hole.
I hit a bad shot.
Mine was probably the best, and I'm short right. So
I hit a bad shot.
That says a lot for everyone else's efforts.
I've hit two.
So let's see what Bruce can do here. Probably make an ace just because.
I think Bruce is going to go in that pot bunker and have no idea what to do.
And we have a third shortage of power on
That's
this
on
tee
the
shot.
Next tee box.
And he is over on the next tee box. He's saving time. Speed golf is what Bruce is playing. He's skipping greens altogether. So we return with Ben giving one shot that nobody should ever do, and that is leave yourself with a direct line, knockdown shot where the pin is tucked behind a bunker. And an uphill shot to boot. If it wasn't uncomfortable enough.
I have no chance. I'm going.
But that means there could be greatness. Distance-wise, all right, but line-wise, he was about 40 feet to the right.
Not 40.
Now we have these two hooligans way on the wrong hole. On a par 3, no less. Tyler took an aggressive swing. And I don't know what that means.
I think that means he's on the green.
That is the walk of a sad, sad man. What? Bruce just dropped and pitched to the back of the green. Gonna have quite the putt. Josh pitching on just off the green. Definitely more would be down here than I was earlier. Oh boy, he's crushed that unless it... Ooh! The one hop stop! Look at him! That's still like a 4 foot slider.
I know, I'm
on the hop. Do you need me to mark, Bruce? Tyler's just long over there. Isn't this beautiful? Tyler is now going. Bruce is nervous about this putt. So am I, Bruce. I have yet to strike an iron shot properly. We are on the fourth hole. But I did chip in on the last, so it can't all be terrible. A little lag down the slope to the general direction of 8 feet away from the cup.
Next up, Ben Cameron for par.
Settle.
And he's got a bit of work coming back.
Man, I hit that so
Bruce for a score. We'll give him the next one. I'm about to donate back the birdie I just made. We found a deer on the cliff. Don't know if that can be spotted. Now for Josh. You guys see that?
Yep.
Oh boy. Good putt. Open putt.
Swing and miss. Badly another swing against the ball, in and out.
Okay. 530-yard par 5. It's definitely windy. Bruce's ball just blew off the tee. This is very reachable with the proper tee shot because of the wind. However, we do have a lot of water in front of us to carry, and the hole is definitely calling for a high cut. Just not that much of a cut. Bruce's driver probably made a weird sound there. Is it making that rattle? I heard that. I bet you the solvent down there. You're harder on drivers than most. If you'd only just make sure his hips didn't lie, we wouldn't be in this mess. He doesn't rotate, it's all arms. Gotta work on that. Not that I should be giving swing advice. Josh has hit another high. That's two splash landings. Yeah. The problem is your cut has to start like at those yellow tees. There's really not a lot of room, sadly. But a good tee shot leaves you in really good position. Well designed hole. Tyler at that. I'm gonna guess, not trying to pump him up or anything, but I'm gonna guess that's 320.
I'm just so pumped up right now.
I think we're gonna have a few edits on this hole.
There might be some.
The mulligan might be taking place.
Mulligans? Who said anything about mulligans?
I am right now. Well, that's going to run 280 yards, probably.
That is the green over that way.
Over there, yeah.
And nice layup.
Didn't draw.
You're fine. You were fine.
Yep.
Bruce is dropped by the water hazard. What club do you have, Bruce? Bruce has got 8-iron. And that should be a good layup, provided it draws back into play. Oh my lord. That's not pin high.
He landed over the hump just to the left.
Okay. Up ahead, that blue stake is the 200-yard marker. So that must have been like 220 downwind because he's cutting the corner? I don't even know. For comparison, Josh has got 3-wood.
That makes me feel like that's wrong. I don't care anymore, though.
Dropping in the same location. Tyler's up, maybe 210 left. Great tee shot. Bruce's 8-iron just broke the world. Oh boy, that's in the fescue.
I thought the wind was helping, that's why I went with an 8-iron.
Bruce, you want to do that?
Tyler's approach.
After a superb first shot, he's made a pretty good second shot. Oh, but a poor bounce. But he might be on the back of the green.
And after Ben's layup, playing the hole pretty smart. 111 left to a blind pin. And not the ideal shot. Maybe it'll bounce in. It doesn't look like
I
it.
I think that's in the sand.
There might be a bunker back there.
Bruce is on this hump like 40 yards short of the green. I suspect Tyler's in that bunker that I forgot was there. Flag's tucked front edge. I'm on the back edge after a bad wedge. I have not hit good wedges and iron shots so far. Josh is searching. That might be good. The softest bounce ever. He's gonna have a putt from the fringe, but it deserved more. Wouldn't mind living in that house. The search continues. Oh, not only is Tyler in the bunker, he's got a downhill lie to a tucked flag, and the cart girl is in skull territory. This is all adding up to being left in the bunker. That's actually not actually bad. That sucks. Josh has a very difficult little pitch. Oh boy. That's going to get a big hop forward, isn't it? Yeah. It's off the far side, going down into a collection area.
Alright, here we are on this hole number 6, this majestic par 3. Where no one is quite sure really how far you have to hit the ball. And also causing issues is one thing.
Close to on.
Yeah. The 150's back here, but it says the whites are like 121.
I'm gonna go second, okay?
That's supposed to tell you where the flag's at on the green. Back, middle, front. It is confusing though. What club do you have, Josh?
Yeah.
I hit pitching wedge. Because we're like scaling a mountain here, the camera doesn't even do it justice. This green's three-tiered and disgusting. It's kind of like two at Crombie, except steeper.
Hmm.
Yeah. That's not up.
That is going left.
It's almost up.
Yeah, there it is.
It's coming back. Oh.
I can see it.
It's really left.
When you have a blind shot like this, it's not good when you can see your ball.
And next up we have Tyler Strice. Pretty sure he's just using some 64 degree lob wedge here.
Yeah, right.
What club do you have?
It's probably middle.
Yeah, it is. It's better.
That looks...
I thought you knew. I told Bruce that.
Short.
Oh my god, what a kick.
I don't know what that hit, but...
How do you get it on that tier?
You would have to land it short and have it trickle down the tier. Maybe that would work, but maybe it won't. And that is unfortunate. Now let's see what Bruce is going to do from the other side. And he somehow... No, it's coming down. At least he's on the right tier.
Still don't think I can get it on that tier. That tier is 10 feet wide.
And now let's go back to Ben for some more action. And he had a little flubby.
That wasn't flubby, that was perfect.
And beautiful. Well, I wasn't saying that was a bad flubby.
And here goes Josh from off the green, just on the apron.
What do you think of the whole location, Bruce?
It's greasy.
It's on like a little half tier in between two other tiers. That's not going to use a backstop.
I don't even know what to say about that.
Would you say oops to describe that?
Very much so.
Yes.
Oh, Dom. Next up we have Tyler Strite.
play it perfectly anyways.
That was a pretty good putt.
That's a damn good putt, all things considered.
And now we have Josh coming back onto the green again.
Bruce with a delightful par putt. This tee is disgusting. It's like 10 feet from this slope to this slope, and everything runs back down the hill. And I completely short-sighted myself, so I had nothing. I was fortunate to make a bogey. Bruce for par. Oh my lord, stop, stop, stop. All right. I believe this is 520-yard par 5. Bruce has got driver. It's kind of straight away. We've moved away from the water now. We're up on the hill. This is straight downwind. And that is a deep draw. That wasn't as deep as I thought. However, it's in the fairway and Bruce desperately needs that. We just came up the hill. There's a twosome behind us, so we're going to hit our tee shots and then let them play on through. Twosome and a card, it's like the worst thing you can ever see behind you. Although we're carding today, thanks to a green special. The marshal just showed up. I hope we don't get in trouble. Good ball. Fire away, Josh. It definitely landed in the fairway. If it didn't hold the fairway, it barely trickled through. It goes uphill. I don't know if you can see it. Oh yeah, I see it. The yellow thing. Yeah, this green I'm pretty sure is well protected by bunkers too, and I think there's a swamp left. I'm not sure. Haven't played this course in 2 years. Unfortunately. Josh with a high draw. That's taking full advantage of the wind. Landing exactly in the middle of the fairway.
Well, that's definitely going to be fine though. Not going to run out as much though because he's in the rough, but that's alright. Yeah, you're good. And a solid, I want to say solid layup. It's going to sit probably, but should be fine.
That's fine.
There should be tons of room out to the left.
Alright, 277 yards for Bruce. Downwind. 3-iron in hand. And he chunked that, but it's going to roll out to like 100 yards, and honestly, it's a good layup. It's not pretty, and Bruce isn't happy. Josh sporting a 3-woody or 3-wood here. Is that still a joke? I'm not sure. Rocket balls here, Josh. Come on. From 270 on the dot. Oh boy. Draw a lot. I can't comment on where that ended up, but it probably needed to get left. What club? Tyler's got 4-iron from somewhere in the range of 240. Chase it up there, leave it short with a wedge, whatever. He didn't hit it real well, but he just kind of drew it off those trees and he'll have a little wedge in. Honestly, why wouldn't you hit a bunch of club and see what happens?
Okay, now we got after his layup. He's got 117 downwind, a little uphill. I don't know what that green does by the hole, but
I think it's kind of a bowl.
It might be a bowl, it might run away, who knows. We'll find out when we get up there though. It's a great line. All right, bounce to the hole, and it's, I don't know what that is.
Is that tight?
I could be tight, might be a little long, we'll find out. Now go over here and we'll see Bruce's approach from a similar yardage. And Bruce is doing the exact same shot. And his bit really hard.
Yeah.
What do you got, Josh? I have 83. I've
probably got 6.
Tyler's got 70-ish yards. Bruce and I both hit really good wedges. We just don't know what happens around the hole, so we could have fallen off. Sadly. The flag looks to be in a kind of greasy spot. Tyler's got 70 yards. That needs to sit, does it not?
Yeah.
Tyler's on the back fringe.
Apparently the name for this course is Northumberland Greasy as Fuck Pin Position.
Yeah, that's another difficult flag. We do have a found ball for Josh, just kind of right of where Tyler was. I think he doesn't have any tree trouble, so... should be okay. 83 yards. Came out kind of heavy. But he got a big bounce forward. And he's long too. We don't know what's happening down by the hole, but Bruce and I either hit really good shots or got ripped off. Alright, so we made it back to the hole, and the hole is literally on a false edge that falls off the back of the green. And as such, I landed mine 10 feet short of the hole, and Bruce landed his 10 feet short of the hole. They both bit, and they both released long. And so we are all coming on from the back fringe. Pretty unimpressive with this hole location, to be honest. Tyler bumping a 4-iron, releasing way too far. Bruce putting on. I'm the furthest away, but I'll play last. I'm really upset. I thought I had a short birdie putt.
I think we both bit quite well.
I know. Considering what we landed on.
And last but not least, Ben Cameron.
How does all this react, and then how does it react?
One in or out?
In. You know, lots of backstop balls here, so. That's like Abercrombie's greens right now, the bad ones.
You're obviously gonna have to move that.
Yeah, I'm gonna take your coin once we ball them.
Actually, it's my coin.
Who's here? Take this. I have a million ball marks. Someone could just ask me. We got a force of middle-aged men on the tee, so we're golden.
Nice pass.
Wow.
I've got Bruce's money.
Josh, take the ball, man.
Yeah, one
second. I picked up my ball.
Saw that.
You can come pick up this camera.
Get to use it as a marker for relief from a cart path.
Yes. Magnetic.
Be careful with those magnet ones.
Four pars on the last for the first time today. According to the handicap, it's the second most difficult hole on the course, which I don't quite buy.
It is when you put a greasy pin in.
Huh? Yeah, when you put a greasy pin in, it can be difficult. Anyway. Dog leg left, 365. Tyler's got 4-iron laying up around the 150. And he started that too far right. It did stay short. However, he definitely has several yards left. That was a coach blocky. Bruce with
a 7-iron.
Coach blocky round 2.
We think I have the right club.
I think
making me think I want more.
All you gotta do is
tee the ball.
Put it at 160.
I hit that way too well.
That sucks. It's there.
Should be just on the cart path.
Contact.
Yeah. Dead in the fucking middle, man. This club's sweet. Brand new club, by the way. You should point that out to them.
Ben hit a brand new club just short of the woods. And Josh is going a little left. He's safe by the looks of it.
We found Josh in the bank.
Well, I'm on the upslope.
We found Tyler and I in the right rough. And Bruce just found a ball in the trees. But I don't think it's his because he looks confused. Anyway, Josh has got gap wedge, pitching wedge. Grounding is clubbing the hazard because we don't play by yo rules. You hit the grass. To be honest with you, that's kind of a silly rule anyway, but whatever. Taking great pains not to ground his club now that I called him out. A frog is croaking.
That's a little terrifying.
Bruce just tried to pitch out of the woods and clocked a tree, so he'll be cranky. Oh boy. That was a great layup. He went right over the corner of that tree with a draw. Tyler playing in with probably a long iron, somewhere in the range of 170. 6 iron, perhaps?
Oh my god.
Well struck.
That's gonna be long, isn't it?
We saw it bounce. Might be long, says Josh.
It's up.
It's on.
He's been doing these shots today.
Not that one. Don't do it.
I hope that's spinny. That's gone, off the false edge.
Jesus Christ, who put these flags in this one?
They're not nice, are they?
Certainly not.
This green has seen better days.
It's the green irregular, I wish I wasn't on.
I know. Really though. They're so firm you don't even leave ball marks. Anyway, Tyler's got to putt through a muddy area. It's all downhill. If you go past the hole, you're fucked. Bruce is having a tough day at the office.
Oh my God. I can't believe that's not hitting there.
I thought that was good. That's short.
Great putt.
That was like the best two putt I've had in a while. Double breaker. Here's Tyler for par from 10 feet. Oh, he just didn't hit it. Had the line. That sucks. Bruce is having a good day. Ninth hole, perfectly framing the view back down to the water. Bruce on the tee after his par. Yeah. Well struck, but with the wind's help, it's leaking right. Tyler sporting some interesting pants today. It's like Spider-Man's off-color cousin.
Gangrene.
And
I'm not alone. I get excited by the little things in life.
I was actually tempted to say splash there, even though there's no water there. Last time I played this course, there was marshmallows down there in the right rough, and I thought they were my ball.
It wasn't the last time, it was the second last time. I was here that time.
The second last time I played this course.
Real, like, actual.
Yeah, someone was feeding birds marshmallows.
Yeah, I'm sure that's good for birds.
Marshmallows are natural. What are you saying?
100%. You see a robin all fucked up with a...
I'm looking forward to my Mr. Big and Lay's barbecue chips. And if they're a Humpty Dumpty course, I'll write a letter of complaint. Boom! Good. Little baby draw right down the middle. Oh. It appears to be deep.
And I can only imagine where this is going to go. Probably like right towards the bunker that you can barely just see in the camera, which is like right on the green's edge. Just Ben's got that much power.
Oh. I was going to say, what bunker are you talking about? I think there's one down there that we can't see, but man.
I was being positive.
It's quite positive. Let's see it.
Oh, almost. Certainly only like 150 yards off that bunker.
Hey, we found Tyler in the right rough. He has to thread the needle between these trees. Bruce is still searching. Ivan. Caught a branch, but it's a pretty good out. It's short, but... I'm in the left side of the fairway, just about even with 100. Josh is, yeah. Josh has got me by like 30 some yards. I don't think Bruce is gonna find his ball.
Do 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 do.
And Bruce has accepted defeat, and he finds a ball, but it's and apparently his. Whether that's a serious his or a fake fist bump, I do not know.
Bruce found a ball.
A ball, okay. Let's see, this is a more acceptable.
Alright, am I good, Josh?
Now let's see what this is gonna do. Oh, caught it nicely. So he's online.
Come on.
And he's pretty much all over it. Nice shot. Now we'll zoom in on Bruce if Ben wants to move aside. And Bruce hits a high wristy. Up in the air, it's middle of the green, to the back of the green.
Good shot.
69 yards for Josh. Giggity. Bruce sounded that funny. Josh has got lob wedge, presumably. I'm in kind of tight, like 8 yards. Or 8 yards, 8 feet. Bruce is on the back. Tyler's pitching up after recovering. Perfect tee shot from Josh. Let's see what he can do. Oh boy. Kick left.
Oh, oh. Oh. Wow. Did you see what I did? No, did you see what I did?
What? Oh, yeah, I know. You stabbed the ground with it.
Oh, I was talking about my gut right here.
Oh, you hit it.
Like a cod in here.
Josh needs to go on a diet because he caught his gut. He was fortunate to not land in the bunker. Okay, calm down there, 69 yards. Little pitch up for Tyler. Not much green to work with. He's going to have to go high with this one. Bruce's wedge rolled out like 20 feet, which sucks. Sick. Not bad. It's pretty good. Not a whole lot to go on from there, sadly. All right, here's Bruce. Straight downhill from the back of the green. We're worried about his speed control. And with reason. It is nice today.
Just take it out, it's not gonna matter.
Perfect weather. Josh, after honestly getting kind of lucky with his wedge, has got this putt. I know this isn't the best angle, but I'm almost standing in the bunker. A hop, skip, and a jump through some sand and just missed the hole. Tyler for quite the par. He's guarding against going long, but what can you do?
Oh, we caught it!
It's called confidence stroke. Yeah, that's what Jordan Spieth says. And he's really good golfer.
Yeah, I heard he might be alright.
He might be, I'm not sure. I just don't think he can putt.
Oh, good the whole way. That looks great.